Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Discordancy. As always, Rock here. So I was getting prepped to start the recording, and I noticed something potentially interesting up here, and I figured we would take advantage of this sighting, investigate. See what the map has in store for us. Hopefully something interesting. I don't know. Hello? What do we have up here? Oh, this is a cute little area. Some little shrubbery, some tree-ness. There's a sign there. Looks like the sign doesn't have any text on it, but... Oh, it's a little house! Look at all the cute little stuff. Firestone blade. It's pretty good. A couple XP bottles. Nothing in the jukebox. Alright, so... Just an aesthetic something, maybe? Hello? Anything up here? I don't know if that's an air pocket. It looks like an air pocket. Swim! Swim, little rock, swim! Bonus prismarine number 2. Oh! Wait, bonus prismarine number 2? Ah, hell! That means we missed the first one. We'll have to consider looking for that. Let me mark this on I2 on my little notepad of prismarines found. I think that does 3, 6. Oh, that does put us up to 9. That is enough for a quick ol. And can I just break this downwards? This is going to be a pain, isn't it? Come on. Break it. Break it faster. Actually, you know what? I don't want to break that. I think that goes right above the intersection. Let's not flood the intersection. Let's just head back out where we came in, which was over there. Alright, well, off to a good start for this episode. To do a quick recap of last episode, we went into our first area of this intersection, the Walkways of Abandon. Found ourselves a ton of gear, these irritated fish, which are going to be our boop item. I think we're going to keep that, instead of having an axe, we'll keep these as a boop item, which should hopefully come in handy, especially with knockback 10. It's ridiculous, especially... Knock that back 10. We got a shitload of them. Which, really, I don't mean more than one. But knock back 10 on a item that doesn't have durability loss. Awesome sauce. Prismarine brick. We need to make bricks, right? Let's head back to the monument real quick. See what the monument says. Because I would hate to make the wrong one. Because I think you can make... there's two types. You can do a 2x2 or a 3x3, and they make different blocks. And I would hate to make the wrong one and sad face. Which way was it? Wait, did the, was there a teleporter over to the, Prismarine Monument here? Intersection 3, 4... Prismarine Monument. There we go. Ah, get a shark here. And let's make a note of that. P. Monument. Right. Off to a good start. What did this say? Here you'll take 9 prismarine shards and craft them into a block. Okay. Perfect. And I did not bring a crafting table. That's one thing I kind of think, just looking at it, kind of think would have been like useful, like right there. Just a random crafting table so you can craft the prismarine versus having to do it at base and then come here. Ha! Ooh. Prismarine block place. Congratulations. Here's your reward. Thanks for the dirt. Glowstone and a prismarine. Oh. So that's two from the Peat Monument. Interesting. And some chest. Are these special MBT chests? Well, that one's not. Chest? Question mark MBT? Chest? Chest? Oh, dear lord. Is this gonna be like a ad infinite? Oh, no, it's not. I was gonna say a near infinite amount of chest within chest that you just give up after a while. Prop 3. A chest plate within a chest within a Prot 3, plus 20% max health, plus 20% speed. That's actually really good. The only thing that's really missing is some unbreaking, and I wish I actually had my... I should do that. I should put my axe in my inventory still, just for situations like this. But really, the only thing it's missing is some unbreaking 3, which I think we have two books back at base still. So we should take full advantage of those. And I do see these here. Are they set up for single player? No. Okay. Doesn't hurt to look. And back to... Alright, two. Yeah, so if we can get some Unbreaking 3 on this chest plate, assuming it's set up in a fashion that we can do so, which... That said, I am going to bring an axe. I left with 9 shards, came back with 2. Off to a good start. So if I can get some Unbreaking 3 on that bad boy, that is actually going to be a pretty solid chest plate. Can I do it? Chesticle. Oh, I didn't even see the name. The chesticle. Yeah. Fantastic. Oh, no, no, come back. No, no, no. Awesome. So, with our loss of health from our helmet, plus the chesticle, we are back at full health. Or probably close to full health. I don't know if it's going to put us exactly at full health. Sometimes it only gives you half a heart on stuff like that. Nope, full health. Awesome! We've just completely mitigated the helmet, or the negative aspects of the helmet with that. Yeah. Okay, so with that, we should be good to head into a new area today. So today we're going to be heading into a bridged, as we're just going to continue doing our left-to-right fashion, which in most cases is... how mapmakers set up their transitioning difficult or their difficulty clockwise in a fashion. Not always, but most of the time. But we're going to head into a bridge today. See? There we go. As a little side note, this apparently that mechanism was intentionally disabled, though not removed. I don't know why, but not removed. The area lead indicator on it is correct from what I understand. However, it's not a wool, and I don't know how the difficulty... Holy shit, that's a lot of stone. Well, I have myself enough building blocks for the rest of eternity. Oh, boy. I don't know if I have enough arrows. We will see. And how much of this is gonna be fake snow? Well, not... Oh! Not nearly as common practice as it used to be back in the day. Fake snow was a thing. and still technically is a thing. Okay, let's go up this side, see if there's anything up here we need to light up. Damn it. Oh god! Alright, back up. I'm actually quite curious and a little hesitant as to seeing that there is so many building blocks. So many building blocks in that chest. It does make me skeptical. As to if there's going to be a lot of section that we're either going to need to bridge or not. Or whether this is just one thick ground that if it blows up, we're good as dick. My dear gas friend. There we go. Need to go. That was a close one. Glad I noticed my health in that point. Okay, let's keep going. Try to... Boop. Oh, the boop item. It's too good. Boop. And apparently, does it have some damage on it? It doesn't say it has damage on it, but given that we only really booped some of those mobs, I'm hesitant to say that it might have some damage values applied to it that have potentially been hidden from us, which could be interesting. Iron sword, I'm going to grab that. Building blocks, bread. Bones. Most of that stuff is not particularly interesting to me right now. Okay. So right now, we're just doing our best to clear the general area. Get some lighting down to reduce the mob spawns. Oh boy. Oh, that is a hole! Oh, wow, I just... Supermaned over that hole, in a sense. That could have been disastrous. All that needed to be done is just get knocked around, knocked just a little bit. Just a little skelly friend. Just punching me right in the face. Oh, that's a spawner. Arrows, take that. Ooh, knockback resist. Armor, fantastic. Okay. Is there a spawner under here? No. Okay. Yeah, see that gold armored skelly that was over there? That's all that was needed. He would have ruined my day. I didn't anger you, did I? Okay. Not sure where this is leading us to. Oh god, there's gas spawners around. Oh, and skellies. Bet there's skelly spawners too. Ooh! Okay, let's back up for a second. Let's get a little health in us. Okay, seems that not all of this is very thick in nature. At least the pathways. I bet if I broke through here. Oh no. Okay, that's relatively decently thick. We're gonna have to be careful. I know stuff like up here doesn't appear to be super thick, and we have gas spawners and such around that we're gonna need to be careful with. It'll in general be in our best interest to keep these gas spawners out of here for future endeavors, if necessary. Oh boy. That looks like hell down there. La la la. Okay. Oh shit, there's a bridge above us. I feel that there's more than meets the eye with this area. Oh boy. I'm gonna have to look into that, into the central area here in a second when I get the opportunity. Oh! Okay, it is relatively... relatively thick of a bridge in most parts, it looks like, which is actually particularly good for us. That way we don't have to worry about nearly as much about falling into the void. It does look like there probably are potentially thin areas. Looks like there are potentially thin areas that we have to be careful about. But... Oh. Hi, sirens. How you doing? The problems, the woes of living in a larger city. You occasionally get those, especially when you want to record. Ideally, one day. One day I would like to have a... I was going to say, do I have to switch to my potion? One day, I'm hoping... It's probably not going to be anytime soon. But one day I'm actually hoping to get a more... I wouldn't say secure. A better location to record. Kind of right now my setup is just like... Right... It's near a window in my apartment. Or actually near kind of more or less two windows in my apartment that... There's a chest up there. It's essentially just in like what you would expect a normal computer setup in an apartment to be, which is not ideal for recording, since you get a lot of noise. I'm next to like my fridge, which makes noise, and so if you hear background noise, that's the reason. I'm in the worst possible place. ideally, in the future. What I'm hoping is to kind of create maybe or put my computer setup in a more more boxed off area. Technically, I have a closet type thing that I could set up my computer in, and it would probably be a lot less noisy in it. Ideally, I'm in the future. What I'm hoping is that I'm going to be able to. Have like a pseudo almost soundproof room. That's my ultimate goal. And I've seen this before on various YouTubers and stuff like that. They have their own like not all of them, but like a handful of them, they have like soundproof rooms, and this is kind of like more of a professional thing that you'd see like sound engineers and stuff will probably have stuff like the almost like egg carton type foam that's on the walls that absorbs like echoes and stuff like that. That's kind of the ideal situation that I would like to have in the future. And I can't imagine that type of foam would be extremely expensive. So it's just a matter of getting a place to set that stuff up to do it. But that's a goal that I want to do in the future. Somewhere where I can do my recording and not have an excessive amount of arbitrary noise in the background or just from like various electrical devices in the place. Because I love my fridge, but it gets noisy as hell sometimes. Alright. Let's see. We're making progress. We're going places. What places we're going? Still don't know. We'll see. Alright. Does this lead to anything? I see a nice little squid just chilling, chilling in that little pool of water. All right, Skelly. Are we going somewhere, anywhere important, or is this just kind of a random offshoot that has stuff? I'm guessing we're going to have to find out the hard way. while I would love to find a, there's a second offshoot. Interesting. Okay, so it looks like there's a lot to this area. Is this silverfish? No. Oh boy. Looks like there's a lot to this area. We're gonna have to do our best to play as careful, cautious as we can. You bastard spawn fast as hell. Zombie, this is not the time. Oh, food. This is the time. Okay, let's do this so we prevent the zombies from flanking us, which would be their ultimate goal, realistically. These guys are spawning fast as hell! Oh boy, this is gonna suck! Damn it. I don't think I'm gonna have enough arrows for this business. 20 arrows. Okay, we need to get in here. Break the spawner. Oh, shit. Break the spawner or two. We can deal with the blazes after, but if we get the spawners down, this is gonna become infinitely easier. We are going to run out of arrows, unfortunately. And I would ideally like to not miss as much shots as I am. Okay. I'm kind of feeling that there might be some spawners in the lava as well. How many arrows do I got? Zero. Fantastic. Just what I was looking for. Okay, let's do this. We're gonna do this the hard way. Go in, brute force. Mailing some spawners! And running! Okay, so we don't have to worry about any more blazes spawning. We still have to worry about the blazes that are currently around. Oh god, this is gonna suck. No. Oh boy. Oh yeah. Can I? There's no chest around, are there? Okay. Well, we found ourselves a prismarine. Let's go ahead and set up quick setup with that. And then make a note of our prismarine gaining. Clear out the inventory maybe a little bit. Oh, my sword is not being happy right now. I can make a quick cobble sword. Throw down an anvil. I'm trying to finagle as much as I can with all of my business. Stay in this air. Oh no! Oh, this is not good. I can't repair this anymore. I might be in trouble. We're in 189. We should. Did they change it 18? I think the previous map was in 17, so it could have been a 18 change that made it so the repairing didn't work. You couldn't infinitely repair with the custom name. I thought that wasn't the case, though. We may be in a bit of a bind. Okay, well, in most cases, we should be good enough to continue. We have our... We have a backup sword if necessary. Oh, no. Okay, let's do that. For those of you who don't know, ice, not packed ice, will turn into water if there is a block below it when you break it. So by breaking the packed ice and then the two ice blocks, we didn't have to worry about an overflow water issue. Okay, spider. I don't have arrows. Oh, this is gonna be a terrible situation. Guess as long as we can keep the bad mobs away from us. Bad mobs being like babies. Cave spiders and skellies. Get out of here, cave spider. Oh, Skelly, why? Okay, to start. We should attempt to do as much as we can with our given sword, because it is not long for this world. So if we can get some good progress with it, and realistically, it's not the sword that's, well, sword is really strong, but it's not entirely the sword that's super strong. It's our helmet. So we definitely want to keep the helmet around as long as possible. Because it does give us the +2 extra damage. Oh boy, I hear lots of spiders. Oh, and we've managed to... Holy shit! we've managed to... Oh, managed to make it up to the top part of the bridge. Okay. Oh no. Hi. Oh! Not today! That's all, cave spider. Not today, my friends. Not today. Okay. We are without insta health potions now. Boots are gonna break here soon. We'll have to keep all of that in mind. Let's just try to get around, get some basic lighting, break as many spawners as we can. And decide how we want to handle things from there. Luckily, it appears that we are on the second half of the area, so maybe we could... As I was about to say it, maybe we could find the wool box. Yeah, we found the wool box. Or, not the wool box, the record box. Oh shit, back up. Wait in the fire. Get food. Okay, we'll give this a second to regen us, but it looks like we found the record box, which is fantastic. Gonna back up here a little bit, see if I can find maybe some insta healths or something in these chests. Something that can make this last hurrah a little easier. I'm guessing we're not gonna have that easy of a time. Why would it ever be that easy of a time? Feather falling. Arrows. Okay, that does help. Okay. Alright. If we can get our sword to last through this last little bit of an area, I think we'll be okay. Record get for far. Oh yeah. That actually went infinitely better than I anticipated. No cave spider. Bad cave spider. That went infinitely better than I anticipated. Do I want even want to look up here? Oh, I think there's more stuff up there. I'm not even going to look up there just at this moment. Might be in our best interest to farm. Might be in our best interest to farm. Ooh, infinity. Oh, I'm grabbing that. Might be in our best interest to farm up there at some point. Or not farm, but nab the loot up there. Is this fake? That's kind of what I was presuming. Hence why I didn't go over there. Might be in our best interest to come back here and do a little bit of looting and when we have the opportunity to, but at this current junction time, I'm not too concerned about that. Oh boy. I would like to just get my happy ass out of here with our record, which I should so happily present upon the bar. And as you can see, I would also like to make this place as generally safe as it can be in the off chance that I need to... Oh boy, there's a lot more. That could be a way to the next intersection, possibly. We still haven't found that, though we've only really gone through one area. So, possibility that could potentially lead to the next intersection. I think, depending on how things go, we might need to come back here at some point. Unless we find the way to the next intersection in the next area. In that case, we probably don't need to come back here, but if not, that would probably be the best place to investigate initially. But yeah, let's continue going this way. So while we run Mac, some random points of banter/discussion, I am extremely happy because I am getting that much closer to being able to work back on site on at my job. So for those of you who aren't aware, I am a developer on the Minecraft Pocket Edition / Windows 10 edition of Minecraft. That's my job. I work at Minecraft or on Minecraft for the Pocket Edition Windows 10 version. I'm not a full-time employee at the moment. I've been working on the project for almost 2 years now, but not full-time at the moment. I'm classified as a vendor. It's essentially a contract person. But hopefully, I'm hoping that changes at some point soon in the future to a full-time position. But at the moment, let me mark this down before I forget. What record is this? Nope, not F5. Far. I'm hoping at some point in the future here, they offer me a full-time position, which I don't think they won't. I think they will at some point. Microsoft has an odd policy of vendors can only work for 18 months before they have to take a 6-month break. However, we were able to work out a way to be able to work off-site for 6 months. So I am nearing, I got less than 2 months before I can work back on-site. So I'm super excited for that because I enjoy working with the team and working on the project in a more efficient manner. So I'm hoping this time goes by quicker so I can do that. Not much of a discussion, but just my random thoughts. Woo! Very complete a bridge. All right. Well, we've managed to complete another area today. I have just the inkling of a feeling that we're going to need to get back into there at some point in the future here. Whether that's in a pseudo-farming capacity or not, or to go to the next intersection, because I can't imagine that stuff was not set up in that fashion to just be for fun. Or it could just be for a prison ring shard. Who knows? But I feel I'll probably need to go back in there at some point. But that is going to do it for today, everyone. Thanks for joining, as always. And I'll catch you all next time. Bye!